I started recording. I started meeting. Yeah. So I'm Subramanya. I'm a full stack developer. I have 2+ years of experience. Yeah. Let's get started. Yeah. Today I'll be covering like introduction to the MySQL, like database, like advantages, disadvantages, and the installation of MySQL in Windows mainly. And the DB creation, like how to create the DB, like a DB administration, which includes like adding a user, like changing the privileges today, like, and also like creation of tables, like the factors which we need to consider while creating the tables. Yeah. So what's the database, guys? Like, we know like MySQL is a like database management system, and what's a database? I know you guys can see the screen, but yeah.
It's a storage where a company stores the data for all the users.
Yeah. That's correct. I mean, not only company, it's like anything we can say, like database, like what we record in the books, also in the table format, in libraries, maybe, like all those things. Like, it's a database, right? We'll be storing the data in it and everything. It's like organized collection of data. Like, it's not like some putting something in there. It should be like organized so that it will be easy to access and can be managed, right? And yeah, that's proper. I'm not saying like that's incorrect, but yeah, like it should be organized so that like we can access the data very easily. So like when we go to the library and we will put our USC numbers or anything, right? So that like we can get the information of the students, or like if it is a company, we'll be entering our IDs so that they will be aware of like which person, like those data, it will be like organized, right? And yeah, like we can organize the data into columns, like into tables. Like the row will be like data, and the columns which says like the attributes. As say for example, in the table, like how we do in the library, let's take the example of library only. Like we will have some columns, like where like first column may contain the USN or like the ID of the student. The next one is the name of the student, or maybe like name of the books which we take, like the after that, like we will put the date, like a start date, end date, everything we'll have, right? So at the top, we'll be having the column names, and like row wise, we'll be inserting the data. The key value, like if we take the example of library only, the key value will be like book ID and the student ID, like which student took the, like which book he took. And also like not only like tables and columns, we can store it as like key value pairs also. The key value pairs in the sense like you can just write student name so and so Subramanya, or like employee ID like so and so. We can write it book name like key value pairs. That's also like one way. Like the main purpose of the database is to operate the large amount of information by storing, retrieving, and managing data. Like it should be like easily accessible, and we should be able to like store large data, not only for small, like large amount of data, and it should be easy to retrieve, and also like we should be able to manage it. Yeah, like I have just listed down like different types of databases which are in use, like centralized, distributed, NoSQL here, like the Mongo comes, like it's like the key value pairs, cloud database, like someone will be hosting, and like there we can store the data. And relational database, which is ours, like RDBMS, MySQL, and also Microsoft SQL is there, and also like Oracle is there, network database, object oriented database, and also like hierarchical. Like in the like among these, like we'll be discussing relational database. That is nothing but like today we'll be discussing MySQL. It is like one of the relational databases. Yeah. So what is relational database? Like it was proposed by EF Codd in 1970. Like it's like in the relational database, the data will be like represented in tables, like which I gave already, like example of a library, like where we'll be storing the data in like table, rows. Like the data is represented as tuple, rows. I mean the tuples is nothing but rows, row wise, and columns represent the attributes, like student name, book name, those things, the columns which represent the attributes. Like since it will be like organized in tables, like it will be like easy to access, like which row, like ID it will be having, like these are the different relational database management systems like SQL, MS SQL, and MySQL, IBM DB2, Oracle. These are the relational database management system. Yeah, it was developed by Swedish company MySQL AB. Now like it was open source, but now it is like owned by Oracle. Like these are the advantages. Like it works on multiple OSs and can be used with multiple languages like C, C++, Java, PHP. Like we can store like these are MySQL is compatible with these languages, Java, PHP. Like we can use it like Django also. It has a client server architecture, means like one server will be running and we can connect like multiple clients. We can connect. It's like multiple users can connect or multiple applications also. It's like one DB will be there running at a time. Like we can connect like DB administrator, he can connect and he will be doing some office work. And like application also, like if I have application of library management system, I can connect and store it. The librarian, like he will be administrator, he will be at like doing some of the things like what he want. So like single server will be there and like multiple clients we can connect at a time. Like it works quickly and can handle up to 50 million rows of data. It can handle up to, but MySQL is like the cons. Since it was free source, it don't have powerful debugging tools. Like it is very difficult to debug the stored procedures or like functions. It don't have a powerful debugging tools. These are the cons. It's not good at handling the large databases. And also like versions less than 5.0 does not support commit and the stored procedures, etc. And yeah, it is difficult to debug the stored procedures since it does not have the powerful debugging tools. It have some tools, but it is not powerful enough to say like where the exact errors are, like where exactly the functions are failing. And also like memory consumption is too high. Any doubts still here? All right. Yeah, okay. Sure. Okay, so like for Windows, I'm just showing like and in Ubuntu, like we have the set of these commands like sudo, it's like root user, sudo apt install MySQL server, and this is for the configuration. Like if you run this command, the sudo apt install MySQL server, like it will install the MySQL server. Like if we give this sudo MySQL server installation, it will ask for the configurations like root, your username, like adding the users, those things. It will ask for it. It's not possible, but let me show this in Windows. I have already installed in my PC, but I'll be showing like where you guys can get this. You guys can see this, right? Here, like if you go to this installer for Windows, here you can get the these installers. You can install like 32-bit, 32-bit. Like here, like this one, 8.0.26, 450 MB. Like if you download, we will get the installer packages. We can install it from here. Yeah, this is the link. Yeah, so I have listed on the like steps, like
So
the
before that,
right
we
number.
so in the previous slide, do we have to install both the installers, sir?
No, no, not like that. It's not like both the things, like one is enough, the server.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Like this one is for Ubuntu. Like if you guys are using like Ubuntu system, you guys can use this. Like it will ask for your root user password as well. Like you have to give it sudo apt install MySQL server. If you do that, like it will download automatically and install. And like sudo MySQL secure installation, it will ask for the configurations.
So I didn't mean
And here,
that,
like,
sir. For the Windows installer, there are two installers, sir. The
okay,
2.4.
only one is enough.
Sir, what's the difference between the two MSI installers for Windows 32?
I've not explored this one, but this one is like this is the one which I have installed.
Right, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, I don't see any difference here. It says like web community and the community is different as well. So like when we double click on the installer package which we download, like it will ask for like choosing a setup type. Like this first step is like which type of like developer default, server only, client only, like full custom. Like the server only gives like only the SQL server. Like we can run it and we can do the most of the things using the command prompt. Like I suggest go with the full, which will give like some of the tools also. I'll just show that. Yeah, this kind of tool also it will be there. So just go with this one. Full. And here in the right hand side, yeah, setup type description, you guys can see like which and all are available under the package here. Like choosing the setup type. If you give like developer default, like it will says like what and all the tools you can get in the this package. I mean, this is not like it's like I need to select this only or this only, not like that. I mean, it's like based on our need, like we can choose like what we want. Like if you want like tools and all, like if you guys are like comfortable with the command prompts, just go with the server only. We can like use the command prompts and we can do it. Or like we can get this full and here like this tool we will get there also, like we can use it. And of course like it have the server, everything it will have in this full. The second one is like check requirement. Here like you guys don't have to do anything. It's just that the SQL like it only checks like the compatibility on like which and all the things like it needs to be installed. Like it will ask like if something is not proper, the this version it says like here it will come and we have to do it manually. Not like manually, like if we even if we don't have it, that's fine. I had some issue with this C++ 2019. Yeah, like I just installed it properly. Yeah, like once the check is done, like it will ask like this download page it will come here. Like we can execute, just hit on the execute button and it will start downloading. Here only one product is there, like since it's like only server only, because like only server will be install server only must. Here you can see like installs only the MySQL server, so it's like it says like this one is complete. But if we select the different things, you guys can see like along with the server, like this tool, the client, MySQL shell, everything will be installed. Like once everything is complete, you can go to next. Here the product configuration ready to configure. like this config type, it's like development computer. Here will be like some options we'll get. Just go with this. It's something like the memory allocation or like these things will be there. Just let's go with the default one. Like by default, the port will be like 3306, and this one will be like development computer. That's fine. And like here, you guys can see like after that, just hit on the advanced options. Like here, it says like use strong password encryption. Like while we are giving the password, like root user password, it's encryption, like use strong password encryption for authentication. This one is recommended. Let's go with the recommendation. And also like here, this is something like admin password. It's like the root user. We have to give this password here, root password, and confirm it. And here you guys can see it, right? Add user. And here we can add the, like apart from the root user, we can add custom users as well. And we can give the different privileges. Yeah, it's like configure the. Yeah. Yeah, like the last step is like applying the configuration and like yeah, it's done. Like once we hit the execute, like the configuration which we selected, it will be applied. Any doubts still? I mean, we can go with the default selections. We don't need to change like customizations. It's based on the requirement, like if you need something else, then we can change it. So it's the database connection. Just a minute. Yeah, for starting the server. MySQL minus u root minus b. Like when we type it, it will ask for the password. We can enter it and your server will be up. I'll go to MySQL. Let's see. The root user. Yeah, as you guys can see, like it is asking for the password. You guys remember this step right here? Yeah, so this is the root password we set, right? Like under the for the root user, this is the password we have chosen, we have given here. So the same password was here for root user, the password which we entered. Just a minute. Sorry, I get wrong password. Now the server is up. You guys are clear, right? About this step, starting the server. So once we start the server, we can do our work. Let's say, like, I need to know, like, what and all the databases we have under this server. Like, the password, sorry, the command goes like this. Databases. Yeah. So, like, once we install, we will have this information schema, MySQL, these things we will have, like, test world. These are all the things, like, I have created. This is the like this is how we can see the databases. For creating the databases, this is the command, like create database. Let's say, like, let us create a database. Management. Just stop me, like, if you guys did get anything, or like if I'm going fast, or like if it is slow, if it is boring also. Just let me know. Yeah, so let's start with the database, like, creation. Like, for the student management, I need a database, like separate database. Just create it. Sorry. Create database. Database. Yeah, you guys can see query. Okay, one rocket. Like, I need to, like, how we can ensure, like, this database got created. Just check this. Two databases. Yeah, here it came. Student management. But, like, how to go into this manage, like, this database? Like, as of now, you guys can see, like, here some of, like, so many databases we have. Like, let's create, like, this is for student management. And I need one more management for library. Database library management. And also, like, for workshop, I need workshop management. Okay, like, based on our need, like, we have created so many databases. Like, how to get into that database? It's very simple, guys. Just use, like, whatever the database you guys want. Like, as of now, let's go with the student management. Database changed. Like, as of now, I'm in this student management. So now it is empty, like, we don't have anything. Now I need to build this database, like, based on our need. Like, how I like explained before, for the library, we will have the tables, like, book table. It might have, like, the book table. It contains, like, book ID, book name, the descriptions, others, everything it can have. Like, similarly for student management, we need, of course, like, student, like, managing, like, after that, like, which branch he belongs to, like, which subject he took, like, if I need the description, like, if I need the info on the subjects, I need a different table for subject as well. So it goes like that. Like, based on our needs, like, what and all we need to cover, we'll be creating the tables. And yeah, delete later we'll do it. Okay, this is for creating the user, like, different user. I'll show it to you a little later. Here, let's start with the table creation. Like, I need a student table. Create table. The command goes like this: create table. Student. डिफरेंट डेटा टाइप्स भी है। And first will be like student ID, top type integer, and student name top type. Can go up to 40. Yeah, so I will explain you this. As of now, I need a table for students which contains student ID, int it's of integer type, and student name of where care. It can store up to 40, and it is something like primary key student ID. Any idea on primary key? What this primary key means?
It's one of the candidate
Yeah, I mean, let's not go not like too technically, but like, why we
that
need
it's
this primary key?
identify the particular set.
Sorry.
It's unique to identify the set.
I mean that candidate key, that's sort of fine, but like, I mean the primary objective of this primary key, what it is? Why we need this primary key here?
It's uniquely identify that entity set.
Exactly. So it's nothing but if I insert a student data, say I will insert my name only, like Subramanya, then how can I differentiate? It's based on like his ID, right? It will be like each student will have like different unique IDs. Like I have some USN number, like you guys have some USN number, like that will be our primary key. In college, if I give the USN, like we can find anyone. So it's like the primary key's objective is to like find that row. Row means that data. That's the primary key. So now just like make sure like this table got completed. Show table. So under student management, I have one table student. So I need to know what and all the columns or like of data type. I need to know like what this table is for. Like I need the detail like that we can get from this. Like describe student. So when we give this describe student, like it says like fields, like these are all like columns. Student ID is one column, student name is one column. It's of integer like data type, and this is of where care, maximum 40, like null, no. Student ID cannot be null because it's a primary key, right? Primary key cannot be null. Student name, it can be. And key, here it says like primary key. I have not given like default values, null, null, nothing is there, right? Any doubts here? Why we need this describe. So I'll tell you like some of the factors we need to consider before like creating the tables. So like if you want to, like, since if I create a table, like if we like type show tables, like it says like what under the tables under the student management, and also like if I want to like know some table in detail, like we can give like describe this table name. It gives like the fields kind of data type or null, like default value, like what under the primary keys, if any foreign key is there. You guys know foreign key, right? The foreign key is like if I have one more table, like I need to join, then I will use the foreign key. The foreign key will be like, it will be in some other table, I will be referring to that. That's the foreign key. I'll show you that. So like till here it's fine, right? You guys are clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, so like now let us insert some data into this. Inserting to student, like I'm inserting data into student. We can mention like what and all the fields I need to give, like this value, like if I'm giving like student ID, I need to mention the column lengths. Student ID, I'll show you. The student name is not necessary. I have not given this student name. So it's like value. Yeah, it got inserted. Now like I have inserted one data into the student table. Like I have given the ID, I have not provided the student name because like it can have null. So it's like by default, it will take null. You guys are clear, right? This one. So like if I want to insert some data into student, like it goes like insert into table name. I need to mention what and all the columns I'm going to give the values. Like I have mentioned student ID. Now this time, like I'm only giving student ID values. One. Okay, like let's ensure like this one is there in the table. Select what I want, student ID from this student. So select statement, it's like I'm inserting into table. Select, I have inserted student ID. Let's only retrieve the values, student ID from student. Yes, this is that. Anyway, I have mentioned like for this, the student will, name will be null. Select. So it's like we can mention like if we have, say for example, student, he will have student ID, student name, first name, last name, like subjects, everything, it's there, like it's a big table. This is how we can provide here the columns. It's like student ID I need, student name I need, student ID, student name from student. Yeah, see, as I told you, like since I have not provided the values, this is null. And also like if you need everything, give like star, like it will fetch everything from the table, from table student. It's just that student ID, student name, you don't have to mention all the columns. It's just, it will fetch everything if you give select star. Any doubts still here? All right, so I need say like this table is not complete, and as I told, like student will have like some other attributes as well. It's like first name, last name. I need that as well. Like how can I add it? It's just you can alter the table. Alter the table. the table student add column name, like what you want, or type char see. Now I have added one more column to the table. This one is fine, right? It's just that like you guys like you'll get some requirement, you guys, I mean, I need some database for students, and now today I'll tell you like create the database, and I need a table saying like student, it should have a student ID and student name. Like tomorrow I'll come and say like I don't need student name, but I need like first name and last name. I need that as like different columns I need. If I change the requirement like that, then I need to change it, right? It's not like drop everything and like create the table from the beginning, not like that, right? So like we should have something to alter the table. So it's by adding, it's this for adding the columns, alter table, table name, add first name. It's like of data type. If it's a varchar, we need to mention this one, like it's like how many characters it can have. So now let's see like whether this column got added or not, like how you can do it. You guys remember, describe. See, it came, right? Yeah. Now I got the first name, and also like my requirement got changed, right? I need last name as well. Let's alter it as well. Give two semicolons. Yeah. See, first name and last name got added. So now my requirement, it's not like student name, right? It's like I need this as like first name and last name, different. I should have to student name. So I don't need this column itself. Like what can I do? Like drop it. Like I can go ahead and drop this column itself. Alter table. Student. Drop. See, now it got. This is how we guys like how we can modify the table, like by adding something or like by removing the columns if you don't need. We can do it like this is how we can like alter the tables or like creating the tables. You guys are clear, right? Till here,
yes, sir.
Right?
It's a fine, sir.
So let's see like if that now data is there or not. Like I have inserted some data, right? So let's see like whether it's present or not. See, like I have not provided anything for the student name, but even if I provided some data to that, like that will be dropped as well, like first name and last name. So like let's insert some new data, insert into student. This time like let's go with, okay, like you guys, like any idea, like if I try to insert one more data with the student ID, what will happen? Any idea? Insert into student ID, first name, last name, values. You guys are clear about this, right? You guys remember this insert statement. Insert into student, values, first name, let's say like last name ASD. Now what will happen? I said like primary key is like it's the identifier and it says like it is unique to everything, like, but I'm trying to insert one more data, right? It shouldn't allow, right? See, because I'm trying to insert one more data where the student ID is one, since it is like unique, I cannot have another student with the same USN or like same ID. There can be only one guy with that USN. Like if the USN is one, there can be only one guy. Like you cannot have multiple students with the same USN. It is very confusing, right? This is the main purpose. Like this is the, like, it's like unique constraint. Like you cannot have a duplicate primary keys. So since that one is done, let me insert something else. If I provide like this, should be there. Yeah, see, the second one, like it was null, it's fine. The second one, which is fine. Clear, right? Creating, altering, insert, retrieving.
Yes, sir.
Again, I will say like my requirement got changed. I don't need this table itself. Like I need some other table. Like I say like, it's like the project, it's like not at I don't have a like proper design. It is like daily basis, I'll be changing the requirement. Let's say like, I don't need this table itself. Like, so like if I say like, I don't know this, this has no meaning, right? In just student database, I need to remove this. Like, how can I delete this table itself? Drop student. See, like I don't need this table itself. Like drop table student. Like if I do this, I need something else. Like based on my new requirement, I will start the new design. If you show tables in this database, nothing should be there. I have created one table, which was student. I did some alteration based on the requirement. First it was like student ID and first name, student name, and later like second day I changed the requirement like first name and last name. So like what we did is like alter the table. It's not like we drop the entire table. It's just that like I needed two extra columns. It's like first name and last name instead of student name. Like instead of keeping like Subramanya Hegde, I need like Subramanya as different and Hegde as different. So like what I told, I design it like this. Student ID, it should be the first name and last name. So what we do is like alter the table. Like we added two columns and Subramanya Hegde was not required, like in the same this thing column. So what I did, I just removed that student name and I like differentiated like first name and last name, like first name and last name by like alter table. I added two columns and I dropped the entire student name, and after that like I inserted some data. And like the third day, like here, like again my new requirement, like I don't need the student table itself. So what I do, I just drop the table. Till here it's fine, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like DB creation, like so like just to rewind, like what I did, like I installed SQL Server, I installed. You guys need to go here, like program files, like where I have installed like MySQL server. It, you guys can see like server in the folder, and you guys need to go like get into this folder bin, and it's just that we can like go from the command prompt also, and like it's just the shortcut here. Like if you type it like this cmd, you will get a command prompt in this folder. So I got the command prompt like this, Windows command prompt. Then I logged in as root user using MySQL -u U stands for? What does that U stand for? You guys remember, right? User. U stands for user.
User.
So it's like, if I have, yes, it's correct, correct. U stands for user, like as you do, like minus P, like P stands for password. We just have to give the password with respect to user. Say for example, like in the next step, I'll tell you like how we can create different users. So as of now, we are like playing around with root user itself. So for root user, I had some password, I entered it, and the server was up. And after that, we created the database. What was the statement? You guys remember? For creating the database?
Create on the database name.
Yeah, create database. Yeah, that's proper. So after that, I created multiple databases, like for some college where that application contains like student management. That is one database. One more is like library management. Like say like we need some management, like I need to build an app, like where it handles everything in that college. So under that that college administration, like they needed some three tables, I mean three databases. One is like just an example. it's like one is like student management database, one is like library management, like another one can have. After that, what we did, like I got a requirement saying like create a table for students. So after that, we created a table. Like you guys remember the statement for creating? You guys remember, right? Here it is. Yeah, create table, table name. I need like after that, like student ID integer, like data types, student name worker, and like in that primary key was student ID. Like this is how we created table. After that, what we did? We like based on the operator requirement, like the college administration, like what we needed is like instead of student name, we needed first name and last name. We added two columns, first name and last name, using this alter table command. Alter table table name. Like added last name of vector type of 30 size. Yeah, and added last name as well, but I didn't need this student name, so I dropped that column. And like then I don't need the table itself, so like drop the table also. Till here it's fine, right? Yeah, just a minute. You guys need 5 minutes, right? Yeah,
so in that. In sorry, the table, can we hello sir,
yeah.
Is it audible?
Yeah, yes, yes, now it's audible.
Sir, can we update the values of null?
Yes, yes, it's possible. I will explain like one by one today. Like we will cover like some of the topics. Like I will explain like yes, yes, definitely we can update, like everything okay, is there, sir. We can delete like row wise as well, like delete the data also, like if like I graduated like some year, right? That student is already a dropout. So like I don't need that student like anymore. So like I need to remove that student from the database, right? So like just removing, that is also possible. And also like so what did you like first year, like I was in some branch. Second year I changed the branch, I need to update as well, right? My branch, that is also possible using like update. I'll just explain one by one, just like now these are fine, right? Like inserting, creating tables, database. Till here it's clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You guys need some like 5 minute break, maybe? Or like, shall I start? This is for like next concept. I'm just creating some dummy table. Just a minute. Oh. Okay. I'll just quickly like tell from the beginning. Just so for like for that user, if I want to provide all the privileges, grant all privileges on to it yeah it's like when I'm giving like all the privileges, it's like all privileges can go here and we can just verify. Let me just refresh. Yeah. Now it got refreshed. See, I gave all the privileges. Here you can see like global privileges, like most of the privileges got inserted. It's clear, right? Am I audible now? I'll just show you that. This is clear, no? Like privileges. it's fine, right? Like granting, like we can mention the privileges, like privilege type, like alter, create, like these things, like create routine, these things we can mention here, and like we can provide the privileges here, or like we can use this tool here to provide, like we can just select like DBA, or like when we select DBA, like everything will be selected, or like we can like select this maintain admin, like here, like some of the, based on his role, like some of the privileges will be like selected. We can just, based on this, we can like configure the privileges, or like we can use this command prompt here, like granting like privileges, like grant, select, or like we can give like alter these privileges to user at the rate host. Like for this host, as of now it's localhost, so it's like we can mention this. This means like any host, this percentage means like any host, granting all the privileges on like database dot table name to create user. It's clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, so I'll just quickly wrap it up. It's already 8. Yeah, like different data types in MySQL. Like while creating the table, we saw like I gave like int varchar, like varchar of like string types, and like int is like numeric type. We can get like different data types as well in MySQL. Int, tiny int, small int, big int, float. While we are giving this float, float means like 0.1, like 1.1, right? Like m means like left hand side, like how many digits, number of digits, and d means like the accuracy, like after that 10.02, like if you give like decimal, like if you give like 2, like 10.02, like 10.12, something like that, it will come. Like it's like place value. Double means like md, and decibel is like in the like decimal values. Like for decimal, it's like we need to mention like m and d, but for float and double, like by default we can get, like even if you like give like float and double, you don't have to mention like m and d, but for decimal we have to provide m and d. Like for like float, like by default it would be like 10 and 2. For double it will be like 16 and 4. Like when we mention like percentage of like float time, it will come in float. We can mention double also, and also we can give decimal. Data types, date and timestamp. Here, like different data types are available, like date time here, like year, month, date, space, hh, hour, minute, and seconds. Like here, like this will be the column, but here in timestamp, nothing will be there. Like this hyphen, these things won't be there. Like it's of this format. And like time is also available, HH, MN, and HS format. And also year, it's like 2021, like that, 2000, this data type. And like of string types, we can give like char. Like char means like it's of like fixed size n. And varchar means like variable. It's like text, when we are saving text, like as we saw, like for student name, we gave like varchar of like length 30 or 40, right? So it's like, it can save up to 40. We have to mention like maximum length. Like we can give like 30, 40, it's fine. Blob means like, it's like for maximum character of 65,535. We can store like large text, like paragraphs or anything like that. Or we can store the image also, like it will be like blobs. Tiny blob, tiny text, medium blob, medium text, long blob, long text. It's just that, like, it's like how many characters we can have in this type. And also enum is there. It's like different data types we can get. And like we saw, like creating, alter, and delete. And like privileges, like creating and altering, like revoking the privileges and also like granting some privileges on database and like creating using drop. These are clear, right? Yeah. That covers like most of the topics for today. Like I mean, I know like I have not used like most of the things. Like based on our need, we can see like tomorrow, like I'll be telling like other classes and like HRs update and delete from the tables, like those things I will show it, and like based on, and I will try to use like different data type based on that. Yeah, any doubts today? Like these topics, any doubts you guys have? Still have 30 minutes left. I'll just show like updating delete from the table maybe, but these things are fine, right? Guys, any response? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Like while creating the table for this student ID integer, auto increment we can give. Like if it is a primary key, we don't have to like mention like student ID, in, like it's just auto increment from 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Sorry guys, I missed a main topic. So while creating the table, we should keep in mind that like this table should be normalized. Otherwise, like data might be like duplicate data might be inserted. Let's just take the example. Okay. Forgot to mention the My bad. Yeah, so you guys know the normalizations, right? So like how it works here. Say set into student. This is a twinkle. We don't have to give this ID. Student name. Phone number. Say like I have a dual like dual sim. I will give you like this is a phone number or like next connect and then yeah, see, I have not provided the student ID, but still it got like some value came, right? One. It's because of this auto increment. What it does is, it's just like take the value and auto increment. If I try to insert one more thing here. Yeah, two it came. Like it will be like auto increment. So like this, it will work. See, like normalization means like, it's not normalized. Say like a phone number, I have this multiple values here, right? It's like it's not at all normalized. So instead, like how it should be, it's like one QW phone number one, like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0, and I should have one more yeah, but here we won't get this primary key because like one, right? Like what we have, what how it should be is like based on this and this, it should be. No. Yeah, so for delete, if I give it like this, everything will be deleted. Just a minute. Yeah, so it's now it's not normalized, I can say, because like here I have like multiple values, right? I have deleted it, but how it should be? what we can do, like based on the student ID and phone number, we can have a composite key. Like this differentiates the this data. Like that we can have, and like so that like this will be in like one NF. Like how we can do it? I just have to alter it, and I need to make this to as like phone number. Test. I'm going to add a constant here. So I'm trying to add a new primary key, but which is already exist, right? Sorry. So sorry about that. So here I was trying to add a new primary key, but it was like I already have a primary key, but on top of that I was trying to add a primary key. But when it's a composite key means like it's like combination of two things. First we have to drop the primary key which exists, then like adding like new primary key. Like this primary key contains like combination of the student ID and phone number. As you can see, like when I describe it, like first now like student ID and phone number for this, like primary key it came. Now table student. Student. Phone number. Values. Thank you. I know I have given utter increment, but still. Now we can say, like, instead of like having multiple values in the same column, it's like now it is mapped like student ID 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like this, it's mapped. It's like 1NF. You guys remember like 1NF, 2NF, 3NF? Am I audible? Hello, I am audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So this, like, normalizing the table, like initially it was like we gave like multiple values in the phone number. So like in order to make it as 1NF, we need like this, like it shouldn't be like multiple values in the single column, but it should be like this, like multiple values, like one, like this. It is, this one you got, you guys understood, right? Like, just wrap it up quickly. First, what I did is, I created a table where I made like student ID as primary key and like phone numbers. I didn't think like I can have like multiple phone numbers. Like I went ahead and like created a student table, but like later I realized like single column can have like multiple values. Instead of like that, instead of making like that, what I did is like I dropped the primary key and then I made like student ID and like phone number as like primary key in this table, like here. Altering the table, like I dropped the first set of primary key. It is like it was essentially student ID. I dropped it, dropped the primary key which already exists. Then adding the new primary key here, like I made it as a like composite key, like combination of these two things will be primary key. This is this one you guys understood, right? Sorry, like I was here, like I was trying to add a primary key. Which where like the primary key was already there. So first we need to drop it, then add the primary key. So now what happened is, instead of saving like multiple values in the same column, now here we are like storing like these values like different, like we are storing it as different data. This one you guys understood, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so here like this, like the table here, it got like normalized. Now still we can normalize it because like I just took this example because see, like I mean, if I have like some information about my address, say like I am from Bangalore, you guys are also from Bangalore, right? Instead of like giving like I mean, say like just example, if you are also from Bangalore, then like you also have the same zip code. Instead of writing all the zip code like 1, 2, 3, like post something and like that, instead of that, what I do is I'll just keep like student ID, student name, phone number and zip code in this table, and I will move this zip code and my address information to the other table. this one you guys like understood? I mean, like what we have to do is we just have to try to reduce the like duplicate of data. See here, like zip code 123456 something we will have, like here also like Bangalore will be there. So for multiple values we'll be storing same values in the same table. My address, like we can have like multiple students can be from Bangalore, so it's like that. Instead of that, what I do is I'll store like all the zip codes in one table like this. Say table address. City. Yeah. So what I'm trying to say is instead of keeping my address in the same table, what I should do is I need to remove this like address information from here and I need to like move outside so that at least like some of the data like we don't have to repeat again. What should I do? Alt table students draw. Student post. Describe. Now it have like these values we have. Why I removed this zip code? Because now it's like a primary key in address. This is a primary key, right? So it's like it's not like we shouldn't allow like some zip codes which is not there in the address. We need to restrict that. For that we need to have the prime like foreign key. This foreign key, like if I add this zip code this to this student, then it will be like referring to this one here. So alter table student add zip code. Okay. One key. Zip code. Francis. Table. Address. Should be like alter table student add foreign key zip code, which should have references address in this table reference, like alter table student I need to add the foreign key zip code which will be referring address table in that zip code. Where the hell does it go? Table student, add column. I don't think any mistake here. Just a minute, yes. Thanks. Type of student add zip code worker Okay. Just a minute, I'm trying this up. Not sure like why it is coming as this does not exist yet. Princess, address. I think now we can. Yeah. Now I added the zip code here. Now it is like, yeah. So here what I did is like, alter the table student tab. I added a zip code of character. Then I added the constant. Like this constant says like this. This is a foreign key. This zip code is a foreign key which is referring address. Sorry about this here. Like what I thought is like this should work, but strange. I'll just check this one, and like I'll get back to you guys like tomorrow. Like why this didn't work, but normally it should work here. I'll just check this and like get back to you. But now what I did is I added a constraint here, like which is like this zip code should be a foreign key which reference to address. Here any doubts? I know like it here it became quite confusing here. Any doubts? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this one is clear, right?
Yes, sir. Clear.
I mean, I know like here, like when I try to alter, like I did like something like this constant, but instead what we can do is like while creating the table itself, like we can have a like foreign key saying like this zip code, like now this confusion, like I mean this came because like when I try to do this this right. But instead, like while creating the table itself, in order to make it like normalize, we can have it like this. Instead of storing like duplicate values of this address, we have to like keep in mind that like where and all, like we can have like duplicate data, and like we have to try to minimize it so that like see, like otherwise it was something like in the student we'll be mentioning the same address again and again and again. It will take like quite a memory. So instead what we did is like we will have a like different table for this address which contains zip code and the respective address of this student. Like if I am from like, if me and you guys are like from the same address, will be the same address, like only one data will be there. What we will be doing is like we'll be mapping this zip code to the student. Like I am a student, you guys are a student, so it's like you guys are also will be having the same zip code, but we'll be storing only one value to the zip code in the zip code this address table. So it's like we reduce the data by like four times. Like if four guys are from the same address, instead of giving like same address four times, so what we'll be doing is like we will store the address in the different table and we'll map the respective address to the student. That is clear, right? I'll just quickly just summarize this. So what we do is like while creating the table, we have to think like where and all we can get the duplicate values. So we have to try to minimize it. Say like, I mean, I just thought of a scenario, it went in a bad way here, but still. So what I thought is initial process, I need a table student where like it contains like the addresses. So, and also he had the phone number, you can have multiple phone numbers. So what I did is, I didn't consider scenarios like this. So then what I did is, I created a student table first, then initially the student ID was the primary key. Later, what I did is, I can have multiple phone numbers. So what I did is combination of student ID and phone number as primary key here, so that like, I can have like different data for this. Like instead of having same values in the same column, I made it like this. Then I noticed this address, like many students can be from the same address. So what I thought is we can have a different table which holds the data of the address. Then we can map the zip code. Then so that we will be minimizing the data redundancy, like multiple, I mean, same data won't be there like multiple times. Initially, like this address was repeating. Now it got like removed now. So like to summarize this part, like this, we can do the like normalization. Instead of like this, I think it's in 2NF now. Yeah. So like we have to keep in mind that like so that the data won't be repeating. Like this, we can normalize it. So here what I did is altering, I ran into this issue. I'll get back this this issue I'll tell you guys tomorrow, like why this foreign key didn't work. And like here what I did is alter table student. Here I added this zip code to this table, and then I added a constant. This constant means it's nothing but this zip code will be foreign key which will be referring the different table. That's what it's saying. This is simple. So yeah, any doubts still here?
No, sir.
Yeah, so To wrap it up, I'll just quickly summarize. I know, like, I'll just keep in mind, like, these things won't happen, like, there's some issues. But yeah, so like we covered how to install the database and like run, like how to run the server with the different users, and like for creating and using and deleting the databases, and later like creating the users and granting the privileges with command prompt. And like this tool was very easy, Workbench. Here we can make use of this, and like we can create different users, and like we can just create, like select it and just apply it. Those privileges will be applied, but for granting, we have to do this grant privileges, and for revoking, just have to remove it, and we have to revoke the privileges so that like different users have different privileges based on my need. This increases security as well. Then we cover like databases, different databases. Sorry, data types. And like while creating the table, I just showed like how we can normalize the table. And just it's just that you guys have to know like what and all the commands you need. So for example, here I needed this alter command for removing some of the columns. I mean, these things are like fundamental. Based on that, later we can like most of the things based on our need, we can check, like so many things will be available. So, but these things we need, like fundamentally we need to understand this database. Like for example, like this was not normalized, then I just had to alter it. So, I mean, it's not like you will know the entire like schema of the table at the beginning. So it's just that like you will be thinking of it. So like that only it was like progressive. So you guys have to know like how to add a, I mean, to summarize today's, like creating the DB for, we have to think about like, say like versioning will be there, right? For some applications, it's like some version, like different version can have like different databases also, or we can have like, one will be like development stage, for that we will have one DB. One will be like it's like for the end users, for that we can have one DB. So that like it comes to us, like we have to keep in mind that we have to create the DB for different scenarios. Just we have to create the same tables in different databases. It will be similar, but the transactions which will be happening in the databases will be different. You guys are like this scenario, you got it, right? The need of like different databases and like different user privileges. I mean, different users means that's just that some users we have to restrict some uses. For that, we need the privileges. We can have like different databases. After that, creating, altering, and inserting and deleting the data from the table. Till here, it's clear, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's it for today, I guess. Tomorrow, like, I will be handling, like, retrieving and like different functions, and like creating the views and all, like, which will be important, and also like joins, like, which is super important in. So like those things I will be handling. Yeah, like today it's like upping the server, like we need to create the DB and like running the server and creating, like for tomorrow's, like we need like some tables and some data so that like we can write the different select or like the need of other things like joins and all. It's fine, right? So guys, so like for tomorrow, just try to create a, I mean, just install the MySQL and like try to create some databases and like try to create some tables and like some in like maybe like inserting some data into the tables. It's fine, right? So let's stop the session for today.